In this video, I'm going to show you how to read, write, and translate simulation data using Python. All of this is easy to do with Pathway of Advanced Design System, thanks to a powerful new data analysis package called PW Data Tools. So for this short demo, we're going to go over three examples of common manipulations that you can do with the PW Data Tools functions using very basic scripts. These are all just going to be a few lines of Python code, and in fact, the manipulations are so straightforward that you don't even need to understand how to code in Python to use them. You can just follow the steps that I'm taking and modify the scripts to work for your files. Every function that I'm going to show you today is well documented and it's very easy to use. Just go to the main ADS help menu and you can search for PW Data Tools. There is a great set of documentation that comes with this package, and there's even real life examples of how to use the various functions in there. So to start, I'm going to work with data from a simple filter, which is shown here. And the simulation is a set of S parameters with an additional sweep done on one of the capacitor values. So you can see the simulation produces a set of swept S parameters. There's, you know, one trace for each capacitor value. And the data set's called simple filter. And you can see in the expression manager all the variables from the data set. It's basically just S parameters and a component sweep in here. So how do you access this data from Python? Well, first I'm going to start a Python session. So from the data display window, I'll go to Tools, Spider, and that's going to launch an interactive development environment called Spider, which is a good place where I can write and use Python scripts. So this is all built into ADS, but I do want to point out that you can still use these tools with other Python environments as well. So what I'm going to do here is start with a brand new Python script and show you how to use the functionality. So the first thing I want to do is import the PW Data Tools library. So I'll say import PW Data Tools as PWDT. That's going to give me access to all the functions that I'm going to need to read, write, and translate. And then I'm going to start by setting the path to the dataset file that I want to read, which is DS file equals R. That means raw string. And then I'm going to give it a string to the file path, just simple filter.dataset. That's the filter simulation we just looked at. Now to read this into Python, I can use a command called pwdt.fileread. And then I'll put the dataset file in there. And the data comes into Python, if I run this script, organized into a structure called a data store. This is all well documented. So to access the variables, I can just do that by simple indexing. So I'll say spsweep equals dsstore, and I'm going to index 0. Index 0 specifies the data block. There's one for every simulation you run in ADS. And in this case, there was only one simulation that was an S parameter simulation. So there's only one block of data. That means index 0. And then to get the variables, I do dot variables. And now I can go to the variable explorer if I run this, and I can find this SP sweep. And you can see that it's a data frame. This is a very common data storage format in Python. It's got all the simulation variables in it from the S parameter sweep. And so if I wanted to plot some of these variables, I can just do that directly on the variable. I can say, for example, SP underscore sweep, and I can say dot plot, and I'll specify X to be the frequency variable and Y to be S21. And when I run that, you can see the swept plot appears in the plot section of the Spider tool. So what I'm showing here is the real part of the response. And I can actually go back to the ADS data display and I can plot that. You know, I can select S21 real part. And if you look at the graph on the data display, of course, this data matches the data over here in Python. You can also, of course, do plots in Python that you can't do in ADS. So for example, I can specify the kind of plot to be a box, and then you'll get a box plot. So from here we have all of the data from ADS and Python. And you know, the sky's the limit from here. You can do anything you want with this data now that it's over in Python. So that's the first example. ADS data came into Python and I showed you how easy it is to access and plot it. So let's move to the second example. PW Data Tools can actually do more than just read an ADS data set. It can also read other types of common data files, like for example, touchstone. So in this case, I've got a measurement file from an instrument. This is an S2P file of the filter. And so I'll specify this path as well. I'm gonna give this a name. I'm gonna call it measured file. And then I'm gonna set it to a raw string, which is just this measured filter.s2p. And now I can use the same read command for the measured file. So I'll create a variable called mej store, and that equals pwdt.fileread, the same command I used before. And then I'm going to specify, instead of the file from the simulation, I'm going to specify the measured file. And that's going to read the measured data into another data store element. And this measured data, even though it's a different file format than the data set, it comes into Python with the same basic structure as that first ADS data set did. You know, it's got indexable blocks, and these blocks contain variables. And because it's got the same structure, it's easy to combine the measured data and the simulated data set together into a single object. And all I need to do is create a new data store and literally add these things together. So I can say combine store equals sim store plus mesh store. And once I have that, the combined store can be written to a new ADS data set using this pwdt.filewrite command. That's kind of the opposite of course, the file read command. And then I put combined store in there, and then I give it a data set name. I'll give it the string R, and then I'll go back a directory, sim plus mej data set. And it's really that easy. So now when I run this, it's going to take the simulated data, the measured data, combine them together and create a new data set. And I can actually go over now to ADS, and I can open a new data display window. And I can now load this new data set that I just created in Python. And I'll add a plot. The first thing I want to do as I'm adding a plot here is to change the view from a list to a hierarchical view. That makes the data block structure from Python a lot more explicit and straightforward. And you can see now when I look at the data set, there's actually two blocks. There's AC data, that's from the measurement, and sweep one, that's of course from the simulation. So let's now plot the measured S21 in DB and also the simulated S21 in DB, and we can compare them. And you can see now they're on the same plot. We've got the swept simulation data, we have the measured data, and as an engineer, you can probably take a guess as to which capacitor value got measured in the filter that actually got built. So to summarize, we read an ADS data set in a Python, we also read in measured data, and we combined them together, and we wrote that as a new ADS data set. And we did that in, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lines of Python code. So that was something that was practically impossible to do before, and we could do it in just 7 lines of code. And the same methodology, by the way, can be used to combine ADS data sets together as well. You can just read them in, add them up, and write the result. It's you know, almost comically easy here. So that's example 2. Let's move to example 3, which is translating data. So what if you have data in one format, like let's say we've got the binary format HDF5. That's actually a common instrument format. You find that in scopes and other types of instruments. And let's say you want to translate a file that's an HDF5 file to another format, like say an ADS dataset. Now, of course, you could use the previous approach, like we took in example 2. You know, you could read things into data storage elements, you can combine them, and you could write them. But PW Data Tools makes it even easier than that. I can just point to the HDF file. So I'll say HDF file equals, and I'll give it the name of the HDF file. This is from instrument.h5. And then I'm going to make a dataset file path for it. I'll say ADS file equals measured data dot data set. And then I create a data file object for HDF5 by just saying dfile equals this command data file, and then I'll put in the HDF file line there. Now to translate the HDF file into an ADS data set, I can actually just use the greater than command, dfile greater than, or it's kind of like an arrow, ADS file. And now I can, when I run this script, you can see the file will get generated. And I can go over to ADS data display, and we can open a new window, and there's the measured data, and I can plot it. I can plot the measured data, so we'll put one of the plots. This is actually S parameters encoded in this HDF file as well, so we can plot that. So 4 lines of code to translate a file from one format to another, that's pretty good. And that's my example number 3. So there you go, 3 types of data manipulation in a simple, efficient package called PW Data Tools. This is just one of the many powerful new data analysis capabilities we're building in the pathway of design. See you next time.